Wind feels great on a nice day, but we also know that wind can also cause some serious damage if it gets out of control. But where does wind come from? What is wind? I'm Nick. Welcome to All Our Questions, where I search the internet for questions that we all want answers to, and I answer them. Today, we're talking about wind, and we're starting right now. The air that you feel all around you and that you breathe in every day is primarily made up of about 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, carbon dioxide at roughly 0.039%, and about 0.003% of other trace gases, as well as water vapors, which are present in the atmosphere in different amounts at around 2%. And that air is always under pressure, and that pressure is simply the weight of the air in the atmosphere pressing down on the Earth. Here's where it gets interesting. If you look at the Earth, you have mountains and valleys and oceans and deserts, all of which create different topography, which affects air pressure. And depending on where the area is located on the ball of the Earth, it can also fall into a different climate zone, which is basically the difference in climate created by the Earth's absorption of the sun's radiant light and heat. All of those variables create differences in air pressure. When you have high air pressure and you have low air pressure, that high air pressure is naturally going to get squeezed in the direction of the low air pressure. That movement of air is wind. Now, for the sake of impact, let's apply all of this to a hurricane. At the center of a hurricane, you have an area of extremely low pressure air. That low pressure air gets completely surrounded by high pressure air, and that high pressure air is constantly rushing towards the lower pressure center of the hurricane. I know what you're thinking right now. Nick, that doesn't make sense because a hurricane swirls. The air doesn't just rush into the center at all. Because of something called the Coriolis effect, which is, when related to wind, the differences in speed between the equator and the poles while the Earth is rotating on its axis. This Coriolis effect causes the large masses of wind to bend as it rushes towards the center, which causes the swirling motion. So you can see, like in the example of the hurricane, the huge amounts of wind that can be generated just because of differences in high and low air pressure. Hopefully that answered the question of what wind is and where it comes from for you. And if you have any questions that you want answered, leave them down in the comments below and use the hashtag AskAOQ or the old one so that I know that you want your question added to the list. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and share it on Facebook or share it on Twitter or any other platform that you happen to be a part of. And if you're not already subscribed, make sure to hit the subscribe button somewhere on this page so you can get more answers to all our questions. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.